Back pain is a common complaint. Pain can start with a single injury, like a muscle strain, or it can develop gradually from the stress and strain of your daily activities. Over time, parts of your spine start to degenerate. This wear and tear process is also a common cause of back pain. Your low back or lumbar spine is a unique portion of your spinal column. Your low back absorbs shock, withstands the pressure from your body weight, resists the forces of muscles pulling on it, allows you to lift, carry, twist, turn. But as you age, so does your spine. Your spine begins the wear and tear process as early as your 20s in men and your 30s in women. Most adults with low back problems seek treatment for their primary symptom, that is pain. But in order to correctly treat your pain, you first have to identify the source of the pain. Well, today we're going to talk about some common causes or sources of back pain, how they occur, what the symptoms feel like, what the best treatment options are for each problem. But let's first take a look at the anatomy or the parts list of your back. I like to talk about four categories, 1, 2, 3, and 4. First of all, we have a column of bones that are called vertebrae, the lower five of which form the lumbar spine or low back. So, column of bones called the vertebrae. Then we have the muscles that start on each side of this column and attach to this bone called the ilium. So there's a group of muscles from here to here and from here to here. These help support this column. The third category is that of the joints. The joints are of three types. There are the facets, which are the joints that connect these vertebrae in the back, the sacroiliac joints, there are two of them, one on the left and one on the right, that anchor this column to the ilium bones on each side of your pelvis. This is a joint here and a joint here. And finally, the discs. The discs connect these vertebrae in the front. These are the discs here and here. The fourth and final category is that of the nerves that comprise the electrical system of the spine. These nerves come in two basic flavors, the spinal cord, which fits in a hollow area in the middle of this column and is protected by the column. And from the spinal cord come the branches or peripheral nerves, these structures on either side of the column. So first, let's talk about problems with the muscles. If, once again, we're looking at the front view of the column, so muscle, here is the column. The column is connected to the sacrum bone. The sacrum bone is connected to the ilium bone on each side. So, supporting this column are muscles on either side that connect from the column to the ilium bone. You can think of this as a mast on a ship that's being supported by the ropes on either side. Now, when these ropes or muscles tear or sprain, this first of all causes pain. Stars mean pain. And also cause these muscles to tighten up, when they become tight, your spine almost feels crooked and has a tendency to veer in that direction. Let's talk about problems that occur with the joints that are called the facets. Well, here is, again, a front view of the column. There are two vertebrae. And on the ends of the vertebrae are these flat sliding joints called facets. This facet slides on this facet slides on this facet, and they do so in an even manner. When the spine incurs a sudden shift, these facets can become out of alignment like this. And cause pain. Finally, let's talk about how the sacroiliac joint, the SI joint, can cause pain. Well, again, we have our column of bones, and on the end of the column, we have the sacrum. And the sacrum is attached to the ilium bones. Well, I like to think of this connection between I, the ilium, and S, the sacrum, I, the ilium, S, the sacrum, as constructed like tongue and groove in furniture. In other words, if we take this area here and blow it up, here is the S side, and here is the I side that fits nicely within it. If there, again, is a sudden twist of the spine, an injury to the spine, there can be a shift of this tongue and groove, such as this. Here is the S, and here is the I, and there is a shift, often upwards, of these two structures that then results in pain. And it also results, once again, in your feeling crooked.